As we welcome you to Sinsheimer Park here in beautiful San Luis Obispo, California, we're welcoming you to Blues Baseball here on the Blues Streaming Network. Hi again, everybody. I'm Zach Ebrahim. Here in the press box at Sinsheimer, temperatures at 79 degrees flat here prior to first pitch. Starting lineup for the Blues being announced. The Blues, if you were with us last night, absolutely pummeled the Academy Barons in Compton, California. Not officially winning. We found out today when we got to the ballpark, the official record of the team is still 4-1. But if you were with us, you know that they led 14-0 heading into the top of the ninth. There was one out to go when the sprinkler system went off. I'm not kidding. The sprinkler system went off, and the game had to be called at Academy Field, at Compton Youth Academy. So it's an unofficial victory. So put an asterisk next to 5-1 for the Blues record right now. But they will make that game up or decide how to score it. Until then, they enter today and will now start a three-game weekend series against the Solano Mudcats, their opponents from the CCL Northern Division. The Mudcats making the trip down here from Solano, a suburb of Sacramento, in between Sacramento and San Francisco. We're just about ready to bring you the national anthem here. We'll step aside, and I'll be right back with you after the rendition.
Members come from Paso Robles, Polanco, and Santa Maria. The chorus invites all interested ladies to stop by during the game and talk to one of their members for more information. The Pacific Horizon Chorus is one of our favorite performers here at Sinsheimer Stadium, and we would ask you at this time to kindly rise and remove your hats.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air. And our flag was in the air. Oh, save us and stars and
it is a firework night here at Sinsheimer. Stay tuned for those after our broadcast. Lucky fans here at Sinsheimer purchasing a ticket, getting a ball game, getting a fireworks show, and getting a Blues team that is red hot right now, coming in with an unofficial record of 5-1. We'll say they got that fifth win, leading comfortably by 14 runs against the Barons. Now they welcome in the Solano Mudcats for a three-game weekend series here at home. The team is happy to be home, getting in from Compton late last night, around 1:30 in the morning. Woke up today, energized, made it to the ballpark here today, and are ready to face their opponents from the north. The Mudcats come in with a record of 3-4. And on the mound for your Blues today, the lefty out of Hawaii, Austin Teixeira, set to make his second start of the season. Here is how the Mudcats will line up. Leading things off and playing shortstop is Tissot Foster, followed by Mark Wolbert, right fielder, followed by Kenny DeSell, batting third. Justin Banks batting cleanup at first base, and Jordan Petrushka DHing. EJ Brown will play center field and bat sixth. Justin Claxton will play third base and bat seventh. Anthony Corrales will do the catching, and Mason Levitt will play second base, rounding things out in the nine hole. The Blues come in with an offense that got back to its scoring ways, 14-0, the tentative final of their last game against the Barons. Sounds like it was an ugly football game, 14-0, but it was just, that's how good the Blues were. And they come in today sporting an offense that does not look to cool down here against their opponents from the north. Just about ready for baseball here. Set to lead things off to So Foster, facing the lefty Austin Teixeira. Austin comes in with a record of 1-0, winning his first start. Only three innings pitched in that one. Three clean ones. Allowed four hits, two walks, four strikeouts. On the season, Foster batting .392 in his 28 at-bats. A threat out of the leadoff spot. We're underway here. Strike one from Teixeira. He's ahead 0-1 on the shortstop. Lefty on righty here to lead things off. Teixeira deals the 0-1. That one swung on and fouled off to the right side. It'll be 0-2 as he's quickly ahead on to So Foster. Shortstop out of Novato, California. Plays shortstop or second base. He's manning short today and leading things off for the Mudcats. Five doubles on the season for the sophomore. Here's the 0-2. Swing on and hit to Ruben Mercado at short. He'll field it cleanly and on to TJ Clarkson at first base, who has to come off the bag and make the tag for the first out. So Tissot grounds out to short. And Ruben Mercado, if you watched the game yesterday, was just terrific in his showing off his fielding ability, helping out his pitcher, Matt Sox, who picked up the win yesterday for the Blues. Here's Mark Wolbert playing right field today and batting second. Teixeira looks in with one out here in the top of the first. Breaking pitch on the outside corner falls in for strike one. Ahead 0-1. Didn't throw a ball in that first at-bat. Only four pitches leading to the ground out. Lefty on lefty here. That one's outside. Ball one. Count even now. Mudcats coming off of a loss by the score of 5-2 to the Lincoln Potters. The Blues swept the Potters in their opening three-game weekend series. Here's the 1-1. Taken on the outside corner for a strike. It's now 1-2 as Teixeira works his way ahead. One, two. Swung and hit to second. This is Ryan Fenn, who fields on to TJ Clarkson for the second out. And it's a ground out to second for the second out. No score here at Sinsheimer. Quickly, two outs in the top of the first. Here comes Kenny DeSell playing left field today. DeSell comes in with a batting average of about .286. In his 28 plate appearances. This is now his 29th. He's tied with Foster for the lead in that category. Swung on, and it's a swinging bunt. Choosing to field it is Teixeira. He will not risk the throw over to first. It'll be the shortest of infield singles as DeSell reaches in his first at-bat. He'll be safe at first base. Still two gone here in the top of the first here at Sinsheimer. We're happy to have you along with us. Temperatures in the high 70s now at first pitch. A nice breeze coming in from right. And here's Justin Banks playing first base today and batting cleanup. Other lefty on lefty here. First pitch. Teixeira actually will check. Teixeira, that is. Checks on first base. Keeps DeSell honest as he singled in his first at-bat. Goes down as a line drive in the scorebook. No one will know how far he hit it, except for us here at the ballpark and you all watching. Teixeira deals a breaking pitch in there for strike one. He's ahead 0-1. So Banks comes in. Batting average of .409. Two RBIs, three doubles, six walks. Very productive at the plate in an 0-1 count here against Teixeira. Taking off for second base and gunning there is Austin Schell. The throw will get away from Mercado, and it goes down as a stolen base. Kenny DeSell with a swinging bunt single now finds himself in scoring position at second with a stolen base. Still just two outs here in the top of the first. The count now 1-1 onto Justin Banks. The Mudcats as a team are batting .285, 46 runs scored. That's now their 14th stolen base on the season. They get a runner at second here early. Here's the 1-1 from Teixeira. That one's fouled straight back. It'll be 1-2. Again, this Teixeira's second start. He is 1-0. Gave up two earned runs in Lincoln. Quickly bounced back, though. It wouldn't matter much. The bullpen would only give up one more, and the Blues, well, they'd mirror what they did yesterday in scoring 14 runs to win by 11 in that second game of the season. Here's the 1-2. Swung on and missed strike three. Teixeira will strand the man at second. DeSell singles and steals second, but Justin Banks strikes out to end the inning. That's it for the Mudcats in the top of the first. Blues bats coming up in the bottom of the first. Here's how they line up. Leading off for the second straight night and playing second base is Ryan Fenn, followed by Mason Grotto. He also batted second yesterday. He's playing left field yet again. Followed by Ryan Cermak in center field. Austin Schell doing the catching. Tate Samuelson playing third and batting fifth. TJ Clarkson moving down from the cleanup spot to the sixth spot in the lineup. Sixth hole, that is. Still manning first base. A.J. Esperanza back in the lineup today, DHing, followed by Thomas Trinka, who will be in the 8-hole playing right field, and Ruben Mercado playing short with that gold glove of his, and will round things out in the 9-hole. The starter for the Mudcats today, number 21, Anthony Galindo, freshman at Solano Junior College, hometown of Dixon, California. He's also 1-0 on the season, an ERA of 2.34. Comes in with 7 2/3 innings pitched. In those, he's recorded 9 strikeouts and 4 balls. Only given up 3 runs, only 2 of which were earned. The righty will look to shut down this red-hot Blues offense here today. So Fenn will lead things off. Last night, Fenn was officially, 2-for-4. 2-for-3, that is. In his second plate appearance, he walked. This is a Blues offense that I'll give you some updated numbers here as I just went off of my scorebook on point streak. If you were to check the Blues stats there, they aren't quite updated. Only because the game, again, was not officially called a win. There were still 4 outs to be recorded in that one. We'll give the Blues an unofficial 5th win. And we'll also give them, unofficially, 31 walks on this season. Fenn, with one of those yesterday, he leads things off for the Blues against Galindo, right-hander. He'll come set and deliver his first pitch to the plate. Way outside, and it gets away from Corrales, who's doing the catching today. So it's 1-0. Here's the 1-0. That one hit softly on a hop to short. Foster has it momentarily. Can't make the transition from glove to hand. And Fenn will be safe at first. That is indeed an E6 for Foster to lead things out here. And Fenn will be safe at first base. So he'll reach on an error. Here comes Mason Grotto. Incredibly, can't talk about it enough, his efficiency with runners on base as he takes ball one has been terrific. Mason comes into today, again unofficially, but we can just add him up from yesterday. 16 RBIs for the Fresno State Bulldog. He's in a 1-0 count here. Is that throw on to first? We'll check on Fenn. He'll be safe. Lindo set to deal to the second straight righty in this Blues lineup. Fenn reaches on an error and will take off for second base. That pitch is taken. Throw into second is just a bit late. It's a stolen base for Ryan Fenn. Both teams will trade runners on first. That also steals second. For the Blues, however, it's with no outs in the bottom of the first. And Mason Grotto at the plate as he begins to salivate with a runner on second base. That one is outside. It's now 3-0. The pitch in to Grotto was taken for ball two. The throw from Corrales was late into second, and Fenn is safe there with a, as he reaches on the air and now steals second. Let's say that's ball four, and Grotto will take a walk. So the Blues bring the first two men to the plate, and the first two men are safe at first base on an error and a walk. Glindo now will have to face Ryan Cermak. Cermak, who went deep in the ninth inning yesterday, hit one to left center of the two-run variety. Ryan with two home runs on this season. Now bats with runners on first and second. Nobody out in the bottom of the first. Takes ball one on the outside part of the plate. Galindo quickly having to work his way out of that one. That breaking pitch falls in there beautifully for a strike, and it's even at 1-1. So, of course, the dangerous center fielder in Cermak. Got to be careful here. That one's bounced to the outside part of the plate, and it's 2-1 now. Blues threatening here early. No outs, bottom of the first, no score. Men on first and second. Throw into Cermak. That one's lined to third. He'll tag third, throw on to first, not in time. That's Claxton who fields it, steps on third to get Fenn out. Now there's one out. The situation, however, remains the same with men on first and second, as Cermak will reach on the fielder's choice. Here's Austin Schell, who pinch hit yesterday. Gianni Bloom started at catcher. Schell came in. Sorry, he DH'd yesterday. Austin DH'd and hit a bunch of balls hard. Ended the day 1-for-5. Takes a breaking pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one. So now it's Cermak at first. It's Grotto at second. There's one out in the bottom of the first. No score here at Cinchheimer. Third home game for the Blues. They're 1-1 so far, splitting a two-game series with the Walnut Creek Crawdads, also opponents from the north. That one way outside, and it's 1-1. The two-run homer for Cermak last night. Just get that cleared up for you. It was his fifth and sixth RBIs. He reaches on the fielder's choice. Here is Austin Schell. That one's lined to third, and it's a fair ball. Blues will score one. Schell has singled and will head into second now to try and make it a double. He will. It's a two-run stand-up double for Austin Schell. Blues get on the board first and lead 2-0. Austin Schell doubling here early in his first at-bat, and he hit a lot of balls hard yesterday. A couple were lineouts, a couple flyouts to left. He makes amends of all that. Gets the Blues on top here early, 2-0 on the 2-RBI double. He's safe at second, and here comes Tate Samuelson, the third baseman, right-hander out of Cal Poly SLO. Local kid. His fourth game with the Blues this season. Of course, his second season overall. First under head coach Bob Miller. Takes ball one. One out here in the bottom of the first. 2-0 Blues. Here's the 1-0. That one's hit out to left. This one's got some carry on it. You can kiss it goodbye. Samuelson homers. It's 4-0 Blues. What a start for the Blues as they are happy to be home. Schell brings in two with an RBI double. Samuelson brings him in and himself on the 2-RBI homer. And here's TJ Clarkson, still only one out here in the bottom of the first. Now it's 4-0. Galindo delivers strike one. Well, coming into today, the Blues had scored, again unofficially, 62 runs. They'll tack on four more here, just one out into this first. Clarkson takes strike two. That's now 24 extra base hits for the Blues and seven home runs. Here's the 0-2. That one drops low, ball one. It's 1-2 onto Clarkson. It's 4-0 Blues. And everyone is still finding their seats here at Cinchheimer. Capacity crowd here on a firework night. Here's the 1-2. That one breaks outside. 2-2, even count. Well, they're getting some early fireworks here from the Blues bats. 2 RBI double, 2-run homer, has it at 4-0. 2-2 on to TJ. Clarkson hits one over into left field, and it's another base hit for the Blues. Clarkson will be safe at first with a single. The only out coming on a hard hit ball to third by Cermak. He reached on a fielder's choice. Would eventually come around to score on the Schell double. Samuelson brought in Schell and himself, and Clarkson is safe at first with a single. Here comes A.J. Esperanza, who's DHing today. A.J. takes a hack at strike one and hits it back to Galindo, who chooses to go to second, and the throw on to first is in time for a double play. Mudcats get out of it, but not before the Blues plate four. So Esperanza grounds into a 6-4-3 double play. And that does it for the first, but what a first it was. The Blues welcome themselves to this home crowd with 4 runs on 3 hits. And they bring 7 men to the plate to give Austin Teixeira the early cushion. As he received that similarly in his first start. That's a trend for all Blues pitchers. If you're on the mound, you're usually going to get the lead and get it early. Blues continue that trend, leading 4-0. We're through one. Here at Cinchheimer in San Luis Obispo. Happy to have you along with us for Blues Baseball here on the Blues Streaming Network. Mudcats making the long trip down here. The Blues made their early trip up to NorCal again for that first series in Lincoln. Mudcats playing their in-conference opponents, the Potters, in their last game, losing 5-2. Prior to that, though, they beat the Crawdads. Game before that, they won 8-7 against Walnut Creek, also opponents from the north. Come into this one 3-4, the Blues unofficially 5-1. And Teixeira will get set for his second inning of work here with a 4-0 cushion. Here's Jordan Petrushka. He's DHing and batting fifth. Awaits the first pitch from Teixeira. 0-1. There's no question the arm swing and the delivery to the plate loosen up when that starter's got a lead. Austin's got it now, and he'll deliver an 0-1 to Petrushka. That went in there, strike two, and he's getting ahead of these hitters here early. Mudcats went groundouts to short and second, followed by a single by DeSalle. That one swung on and missed strike three. Austin Teixeira has his first strikeout, and it's the first out here at the top of the second. It's now 2 strikeouts for him on the day, and officially 6 on the season in his 4 1/3 innings pitched so far. Here comes E.J. Brown. He hits one over to Samuelson at third. Grounds that one on a hop. Fields it on a hop. Excuse me. Throws on to first for the second out. Brown grounds out to third. Samuelson, of course, jacked up after he jacked one out of here. 2-run homer that made it 4-0. Here comes Justin Claxton. He's manning third base today. 2 outs, top of the second, 4-0 Blues here in San Luis Obispo. That one is hit on a hop to Samuelson again. He'll come on and unable to get that one in his glove cleanly. Took an awkward hop, ranged on quickly. Let's see how they score that one. We'll wait for the official ruling. Nonetheless, Claxton is safe at first. ruled a single. Claxton safe at first on the second base hit of the day for the Mudcats. That first pitch is low. It gets away from Shell, and Claxton will take off for second. He's safe at second now. That's what happened for the Mudcats. They singled, and it was Kenny DeSell who stole second. Corrales now at the plate, batting with a man in scoring position. His team already trailing 4-0 and a chance to chip away here with two outs in the top of the second. Teixeira delivered a ball on the first pitch, a strike on the second, and it's even to Anthony Corrales. He'll look in and get the sign from Austin Shell. The lefty will check second. Comes set and deliver to the plate. Started his delivery with his head still pointed towards second base. Delivers a ball outside. Fastball, that is. 2-1 now. Here's a 2-1. That one is hit to Samuelson again. He's been busy. He'll take it and field it over to first. So he guns it to TJ Clarkson, and that does it for the Mudcats in the second. They'll get one base hit, bring four men to the plate, but are unable to strike. They'll go strike out, ground out, single, and another ground out. Claxton advanced to second, but unable to come around to score. That does it for the Mudcats in the second. Blues bats will be up with a four-run lead here early. And Teixeira has given up only two base hits. Nothing to show for it for Solano. And he's through two relatively clean. Austin upping the strikeout total on the season to 6. We'll await the Blues bats. In the bottom of the second, leading things off for them will be Thomas Trinka getting the start today. He did indeed pinch hit yesterday. He pinch hit. And actually drove in a run on an RBI single. So he had a productive pinch hit appearance. Bats eighth today, followed by Ruben Mercado. And it's still Anthony Galindo out there, set to start his second inning of work. The four runs in the top of the first bring him up now to 7 runs on the season given up, 6 of which are earned. Walked Grotto. That was his 5th walk on the season. The Blues have done this to opposing pitchers, though. Aside from the opening day start for Walnut Creek, opening day starter, I should say, here at Cinchheimer, every hitter has left San Luis Obispo with a ERA higher than when they entered. Nonetheless, here comes Thomas Trinka. Leading off the inning and quickly fouling one off to the right side, into the crowd and above the Blues dugout. It's 0-1. Bottom of the second here, just underway. 4-0 Blues. Here's the 0-1. That one's hit to second. Foster fields it cleanly and throws on to first for the first out. So Trinka grounds out to short to lead things off for the Blues. AJ Esperanza hit into a double play. That ended the first inning. Trinka grounds out to short here for the first out. And here's Ruben Mercado. Mercado, San Jose State, awaits the first pitch. Galindo hits him, plunked him right in, right on the inside part of his rib cage. Ruben, without any hesitation, will take first base as he is hit by a pitch with one out here in the bottom of the second. For the Blues now, two men were hit by a pitch yesterday. Now Mercado is hit. That's now 9 men that have been hit by pitches for the Blues on this season. It happened in back-to-back at-bats. TJ Clarkson was hit in the 4th. As this one is hit on a hop to short, they'll field on to second and on to first, only getting one out on the attempted double play. So they'll get the leadoff man out. or the man who, they'll get Mercado out, but Fenn will hit that one, is safe at first now, trading places with Ruben. There's now two outs in the bottom of the second. Still 4-0 Blues. Galindo getting two outs quicker than he did in the first, and now dealing to Mason Grotto, ball one in the dirt. Back to the hit by a pitch. So TJ was hit in the fourth. That drove in a run. The bases were loaded. And then Tate Samuelson was hit in the at-bat following. That also drove in a run as the bases remained loaded. So of nine of those men that have been hit, as that one is ball two, of the nine men that have been hit, two of which brought in runs and added to their RBI total. Their run total, I should say. Fenn safe at first. Grotto at the plate. Takes ball three on the breaking ball. Fenn reaching on the fielder's choice. Stole a base. Back in the first as he reached on an error. Galindo deals strike one to the plate. It's now 3-1. 3-1 on to Mason Grotto. Grotto hits one into right field. That'll be a base hit. Fenn will he'll stay at second. So it'll be men on first and second for the Blues as Grotto singles. He's now reached in both his plate appearances, as has Ryan Fenn. Grotto now walked and singled. And here comes Ryan Cermak, who reached on a fielder's choice. Blues threatening again. Now two outs in the bottom of the second, already leading 4-0. Cermak takes a breaking ball that gets away from Corrales momentarily. In the process, runners will advance to second and third on the pass ball. Count now 1-0 to Cermak. Here's the 1-0. Ryan takes high, ball two. Men now at second and third for the Blues. It's Fenn at third and Grotto at second. And Cermak at the plate. Homered last night. Swung on and missed. Down 2-1. Ryan going for that third homer of the season. He's hit two. That leads the team in that category. Here's the 2-1. Breaking pitch. It's away from Corrales momentarily, but he'll field it. No one advances, and it's 3-1 now. The same count that Cermak homered in last night. And the hitters count now. Galindo awaiting to deal the fourth pitch of this at-bat. It's the most fans we've seen here at a Blues game. That one's popped up. Cermak going for another homer. Hits it high and deep, but foul. Count now full at 3-2. Runners on second and third for the Blues. Two out in the bottom of the second. They lead 4-0. That one is hit foul, and it nibbles its way to the Mudcats dugout. We'll do it all over again. Situation remaining the same. Full count. Galindo set to deal another payoff pitch. Here it is. That one is behind Cermak. In the process, it gets to the backstop, and Fenn will come around to score for the fifth run for the Blues on the day. And how many times are we going to see pitches be thrown either above the head of Blues bats or behind them? Obviously not intentional. Got away from Galindo. The walk and the wild pitch bring in the fifth run for the Blues on the day. It's 5-0. And here comes Austin Schell, who drove in the first two runs on the day on a 2-RBI double. Runner takes off for second. Cermak will be safe at second. Now trying for third. In the process, Grotto will come around to score from third. The throw over to third sails over Claxton's head. But another pitch that gets to the backstop will bring in the sixth run for the Blues. It's 6-0 here. Cermak safe at third. And Schell is still at the plate in a 1-0 count. Cermak comes around to score. The three men at the top of the lineup for the Blues have all reached in both their at-bats. Here's Schell, who his double back in the first was his third extra base hit of this season, and it drove in his sixth and seventh RBIs. Two-oh count now. Two outs, bottom of the second. Cermak at third, and it's 6-0 Blues. Galindo, fastball high and inside, makes it 3-0. And if Schell is to reach, that'll bring up Tate Samuelson, who did more damage in the first on a two-run homer. Here's the 3-0. In there, strike one. So Schell taking. Cermak, who walked, is safe at third. Advanced from first to third on a throw that got away. 3-1, hit on a line and passed Claxton at third base. Cermak will score. Schell digging and will try to head into second. The throw from left is not in time. Oh, they'll say it is. Looked like Schell got there, but the throw was gunned in from DeSalle. And as Schell tried for two, he is called out, but not before the Blues tack on three more. It's 7-0 Blues. So it's 7-0 Blues through two. Teixeira with a more than comfortable cushion, set to start his third inning of work. I'm going to take a short break and be right back with you on the Blue Streaming Network. Thanks for hanging out. As we start the third here in San Luis Obispo, capacity crowd, and I mean capacity. Not a lot of seats empty and not a lot of grass empty either above those, as it's fireworks night. And the Blues have had early fireworks from their offense. They lead 7-0. Teixeira set to start his third inning of work and will pitch to Mason Levitt. Levitt takes ball one outside. Levitt manning second base today. So Schell did indeed bring in the seventh run on the day for him and the Blues. That was his eighth RBI. Thrown out at second, however, to end the inning. And it's the top of the third as Teixeira deals way inside. It's 2-1. No outs, top of the third, 7-0 Blues. Here's the 2-1 from Teixeira. That one's fouled straight back, and it's 2-2. Count even at 2-2. Here's Teixeira to the plate. That one outside going with the fastball, and it's full now at 3-2. Payoff pitch. In there, strike three called, and he got him looking. Third strikeout of the day for Teixeira, his seventh on the season. The first two were swinging. That one left Levitt petrified, and he got him looking. One out, top of the third, 7-0 Blues, and we'll work our way back to the top of the Mudcats lineup into So Foster, who takes strike one. Oh, one. That one's hit to Samuelson at third. He'll field it cleanly and gun on to first. Safe, however, is Foster as it pulled TJ Clarkson off the bag. So Foster reaches. That one for two on the day.
And batting number 18, the right fielder, Mark Wolbert.
Here's Mark Wolbert, who grounded out to second in his first AB. Gun over to first, and he picked him off. Teixeira from the left side of the mound gunned it over to first, got Foster. Bases are now cleared, and now there's two outs in the top of the third. Wolbert hasn't even seen a pitch. So after Foster reaches, a pitch later, he is out. And here's Teixeira, lefty on lefty, dealing a breaking pitch that falls in there for strike one. Here's the 0-1. That one swung on and missed. Two outs, top of the third, 7-0 Blues. Oh, 2. In there, ball one. Here's the 1-2. Breaking ball fell in there for strike three, and he got him looking. And that ends the inning. Teixeira through three has struck out four and has held them scoreless. Still 7-0 Blues. And with the Blues leading comfortably, and we'll await their bats in the bottom of the third. Just want to give a shout out to some of our amazing sponsors, namely Via Automotive, a sponsor of the Blues since 1946, since the team became a team here in SLO. If you're in need of any auto repairs, go check out Via Automotive, our friends over there, where their slogan is, "Our family, taking care of your family." Via Automotive.
Families who are here in Texas, we couldn't do it without you. And we know there are some folks who have come all the way down from Solana to enjoy the Central Coast and spend time cheering for their fans.
Galindo set to start his third inning of work. Mudcats trailing 7-0. Has not gone the way Anthony was anticipating his start today would go, but that's how hot this Blues offense is right now, and it'll be the man who homered back in the first to make it 4-0. It's Tate Samuelson. One for one with the two-run dinger on today. It's his second at-bat. The first pitch. Galindo fools him. Breaking pitch as it swung through, and it's 0-1. And two now. That one falls on the outside corner. Quickly ahead on Samuelson. Oh, two. One high went with the fastball, and it's 1-2. Samuelson takes a breaking ball away. He's worked it back to even at 2-2. That one's low, and the count will be full at 3-2. Here's the payoff pitch, Galindo to the plate. That breaking pitch falls in there, and he got him strike three. So Samuelson will strike out looking in his second at-bat. Here in the bottom of the third, it's 7-0 Blues, and here's TJ Clarkson, who singled in his first at-bat. He's 1-for-1 on the day. Takes ball one. One out, bottom of the third. Blues leading comfortably. After the 14 runs they scored last night against the Barons, they're already halfway there. And we're not through three. Here's the 1-0. That one in there for strike one. We're even at 1-1 in the count. That one a bit inside, and it's 2-1. Breaking pitch falls in there for strike two, and Galindo's got that pitch working here in the third. Through 2 1/3 innings, count is even on Clarkson. He fouls that one off to the right side, and we'll do it all over again. Two-two. That one's lined into right. TJ is 2-for-2 with two singles. Here comes Esperanza, who grounded out to short. It was a double play. So grounded into a double play in his first at-bat. That ended the first inning. He'll step up now with a runner on first in the form of TJ Clarkson. And one out here in the bottom of the third. San Luis Obispo leading by seven. First pitch is in the dirt for ball one. That one's fouled off. First pitch was a strike. My mistake, it's 0-2 on Esperanza. The runner at first is TJ Clarkson. He just singled to right. 0-2. That one is hit softly but foul. Esperanza in the 0-2 hole here with one out in the third. Here's the 0-2. Esperanza fouls another one off. Fouls another one off, and he'll stay alive. It's still 0-2. Blues already with five hits on the day. That one is low and outside. Ball one. Can't say enough about this offense. Have now walked 33 times on the season. Last night, as that pitch is low for ball two, it's even now at 2-2 on Clarkson. In last night's game, 14 runs, only two extra base hits for the Blues. A double by Tate Samuelson. That led off the ninth inning. And then a two-run homer by Cermak, also in the ninth inning. So up until that point, as Esperanza fouls another one off, it's still 2-2. So up until that point, it was 8-0. They'd score six runs in the ninth. And in the process of Tate Samuelson taking his second at-bat of the ninth inning, the sprinkler systems came on and the game had to be called. That's why we're saying unofficially the Blues are 5-1. Swung on and missed by Esperanza. We'll go down swinging, now 0-for-2 on the day, and Here comes Thomas Trinka, who grounded out to short in his first AB. Two outs, bottom third. Trinka hits one softly to short. Foster has it and throws on to first for the third out. That'll end the inning. But through three, it's 7-0 Blues. They played four in the first. They played three in the second. None in the third. And we'll head to the fourth. And the Mudcats bats will start things or lead things off in the top of the fourth. And Austin Teixeira will be out there set to start his fourth inning of work in this. And we saw this yesterday from Matt Sox, who was dominant through three, went through three in his first start, then went ahead and Coach Miller put him out there for four. We're seeing the same situation here. Austin, terrific through three, now getting out there for a fourth inning of work, and obviously the cushion playing a factor. Of course, some room for error, but Teixeira will pitch his seventh inning of the season. Coming up in just a moment. I'm going to take a short break. I'll be right back with you on the Blue Streaming Network. Thanks for hanging out. We'll start the fourth with the ground out to second. That was Kenny DeSalle at the plate. Single back in the first. Grounds out to second here to start off the fourth. And it's one pitch and one out for Teixeira. Here's Justin Banks. Struck out swinging in his first at-bat. That ended the first inning. Awaits the first pitch from the lefty Teixeira, breaking ball at low, ball one. Here's the 1-0. That went outside, ball two. Two oh now. Thought about swinging. It was a strike anyway. 2-1. That one's hit softly to Fenn. Plays it on a hop and throws on to first for the second out. Fenn getting work here in back-to-back at-bats. Two ground outs to second in the top of the fourth here for the Mudcats. Still trailing 7-0. Blues looking for that second win at home as Jordan Petrushka will head to the plate. He also struck out swinging in his first at-bat. He's 0-1 on the day, and the righty at the plate awaits the first pitch from the lefty on the mound. That one's a fastball high and outside. Ball one. Petrushka awaits the 1-0. That one swung on and hits softly. Teixeira will field it and toss on to first to retire the side. So the Mudcats go quietly in the fourth. Three ground outs get Teixeira out of the fourth. Clean. And he sets them down 1-2-3. Blues will bat with that 7-0 lead still up on the scoreboard. Anthony Galindo going to be out there for his fourth inning of work. Going to mirror that output. President, head coach, and general manager of the Mudcats, Ben Crombie, sending Galindo out there for a fourth inning of work. While we have a moment, also want to thank another one of our generous sponsors, Club Cannon. Club Cannon responsible for all our CO2 cannons here at Sinsheimer. When the runs score, they'll go off. And I imagine we'll see them also going off. We've seen them already go off a bunch here in this one. When the fireworks are happening as well, as it's fireworks night here at Sinsheimer. Club Cannon, premium special effects equipment for any of your needs. Check out clubcannon.com. Here's Ruben Mercado, who will lead off the bottom of the fourth with his team leading by 7. Ruben was hit by a pitch in his first at-bat. That was in the first pitch he saw of the AB. Galindo plunked him. He took first base. But it would be relatively harmless. And here's the first pitch from Galindo in the fourth. That one's outside, ball one. Hit foul to the left side. It's 1-1. Mercado pops that one up. Infield has to come on, and it's Foster at short. He catches it for the first out, so Mercado pops up to short to start off the fourth for the Blues. Here's Ryan Fenn to bat with one out in the bottom of the fourth. Take strike one from Galindo. Ruben has seen one pitch that hit him and two pitches that he popped up. 0-for-2 on the day. Here's Fenn, who has reached both times. Reached on an error back in the first. Reached on a fielder's choice back in the second. And in a 1-1 count here with one out of the bottom of the fourth. Takes that one low, ball two. Here's the 2-1 from Galindo. A breaking pitch. Falls in there, but not for a strike. It's 3-1. Here is the 3-1, and he takes outside for ball four. So Fenn will take a walk and has now reached in all three of his plate appearances. Walk totals continue to mount for the Blues on this 2021 season. Just last night, they took 6. 7, in fact. I've already taken 3 today. First pitch to Grotto was a ball. Here's the second pitch. Also a ball. 2-0. Mason Grotto, he's reached in both his appearances. He's got one of those walks today and has also singled. Bats with Fenn on first, one out in the bottom of the fourth. Fenn takes off for second. Grotto swings away and fouls it off. In the process, Fenn will have to retreat back to first. Grotto playing left field today. We've seen him play 3 positions when Tate Samuelson hadn't joined the team yet. He was the third baseman. As soon as Tate joined, he was the second baseman. Throw over to Fenn at first. Checks on him. He's safe. And now the past 3 games, maybe 4, he's been playing left field. And maybe in that position permanently with Samuelson. back and playing third. That one's grounded to third, and it's 2-2. Count even on Grotto. Fenn still at first. One out in the bottom of the fourth. It's 7-0 Blues. Looking for, I guess you could call it their official sixth win. This one's popped up. On the outfield, Brown out in center has it. He'll field it cleanly. That's the second out here in the fourth for the Blues. Here's Ryan Cermak. Five-tool center fielder. Chicago is indeed his hometown. Out of Illinois State. Ben takes off for second. That one's fouled off. Drifting to foul territory and right. And Fenn tried to steal. Thought about taking three as well. Third, that is. Fenn heads back into first. It's 0-1 on Ryan Cermak. It's 7-0 Blues. Lindo checks on Fenn at first. Still safe. 0-1 on Cermak. Throw over to first again. Checks on Fenn. Fenn already with a stolen base in this one. He did that back in the first. Cermak has reached on a fielder's choice and walked. There's a 0-1 count. Here it is. That one swung on and it's looping into right center. It'll drop. So Cermak has a double. Fenn is into third. They'll hold him there. Runners on second and third for the Blues as they threaten here in the bottom of the fourth. They already lead 7-0. And here's Austin Schell, who drove in the first two runs back in the first. He's actually driven in three of their seven runs so far. So Schell at the plate, batting from the right side with ducks on the pond yet again. It's Cermak at second and Fenn at third. Two outs, bottom of the fourth. Takes the first pitch in the dirt for ball one. One and zero on Schell. Drove in a run back in the second, and in the process was safe at first. Tried to be safe at second, and was called out, but not before the seventh run scored. Here's the 1-0. That one a similar pitch in a similar spot, and it's 2-0 as Schell has worked his way ahead on Galindo. Galindo just an out away from getting out of this jam. Blues did all their work with one out back in the first. Here's the 2-0. That one drops in there for a strike. It's 2-1. Cermak, who just doubled, has Fenn at third now, who walked to lead off the inning. That was after Mercado popped up. 2-1. That one outside, and it's 3-1. So not challenging Schell here so far. And he's ahead with two outs in the bottom of the fourth. This team leading 7-0, halfway to the amount of runs they scored last night in an unofficial fifth victory. That one high, and Schell will take a walk. Bases will be loaded for Tate Samuelson. May I remind you, he homered back in. Conference on the mound, meeting of the minds, I like to call it. We'll see the situation here. Mudcats have had a right-hander warming. Not sure if that's Ben Crombie out there or Jared Carr, the pitching coach. I'll know in just a moment. It was Jared Carr and just a quick conversation with Galindo Anthony, who obviously gave up the two-run homer to Samuelson. That made it 4-0. Blues have tacked on 3 cents, a chance to tack on more here in the bottom of the fourth with the bases loaded and Samuelson at the plate. Here's the first pitch. Tate takes a breaking ball high, ball one. That one taken in the dirt, ball two. Checked his swing, and they'll say he didn't go around. 7-0 Blues, two outs, bottom of the fourth. Bases loaded for Tate Samuelson, who has driven in two on a homer and struck out looking. Here's the 2-0. Takes strike one, a generous call on the outside corner. Here's the 2-1 from Galindo. Samuelson takes high ball, strike two, excuse me. Count even at 2-2. After being ahead 2-0, Galindo has worked his way back in the count and quickly deals the 2-0. That one drops in there for strike three. Breaking pitch fooled him. And Tate will strike out looking for the second time today, stranding the bases loaded. Blues still lead 7-0. Oh, we'll keep it here. PA announcer Jim Niebert going to take us through the Dizzy Bat Race here at Sinsheimer and the first appearance of the season for the Blues mascot. One of the many great things they do with the kids here that choose to come out to Sinsheimer with the folks. Enjoying a dominant Blues performance so far. And here we go. The objective to spin around the bat seven times and then race on opposite base paths. One going up, and this is the second time this has happened, both going the same way to third. And right now the race is not too close. We hope you can make it out to a Blues game here sometime soon. Fireworks night tonight. Team leading 7-0 and playing great baseball. Welcoming the Mudcats for a three-game weekend series. They came down here from the north. Trying to play spoiler here at home. It's all Blues so far. New pitcher out there for the Blues. We'll introduce you to him in just a moment. I'm going to take a short break here on the Blues Streaming Network. New pitcher for the Blues is right-hander making his pitching debut out of the bullpen. It's A.J. Kostic. A.J., we've seen him bat a couple times already in the Blues lineup, but here he is on the mound with a 7-0 lead, and Coach Miller deploying him to face E.J. Brown to lead things off. Brown 0-for-1 on the day. He's grounded to third. Here's A.J. Did not start pitching until his sophomore year of high school. Team needed pitchers, and he said it was something he had had success doing, as Brown fouls that one off. AJ ahead 0-1, but he said, I served as the team's closer. So that's interesting. They put you into that position. And he said, yeah, and they only wanted me pitching when the game was close. I said, that's even more interesting. Pitching was new to him, and if the game's close, you want, I guess, someone out there who's taken the reps, but gets ahead here on Brown as he swings and misses 0-2. But AJ said, I was getting frustrated. The games were never close. We were either blowing the team out or we were getting blown out, and I never got in the game. So maybe the team knew what they were doing. AJ fresh to pitching, getting a chance to show out here on the mound. The righty delivers the 0-2 to Brown. Gets him to foul that one off. He's thrown nothing but strikes in three pitches. Kostic shakes off the first sign from Schell. Now delivers the 0-2. In there, strike three called. Got him looking. So Kostic says hello to the 2021 season on the mound, that is, with a strikeout. Here comes Justin Claxton. He singled and has one of the two. One of the three, I believe. I'll get it sorted out for you. He's got one of the couple hits for the Mudcats here today. Here's the first pitch from Kostic. Breaking pitch. That one falls in there for a strike. So nothing but strikes in five pitches now. We're starting the fifth here at Sinsheimer. Top five, 7-0 Blues. One out. Here's the 0-1. Quickly delivering. That one's popped up. Schell has a look behind the plate, and he will field it cleanly for the second out. So a pop out behind the plate has Claxton out. That's the second out here in the top of the fifth. Here is the Mudcats catcher, Anthony Corrales, who grounded to third in his first AB. Kostic has thrown nothing but strikes and has gotten two quick outs. That one nips the outside corner, but not for a strike. 1-0. First ball AJ delivered. He had me cracking up when he was telling me that story. He said, I never got in the game. I thought I was a good pitcher. They never wanted me in the game. Swung on and missed there. It's 1-1. But he's getting a chance here to show Coach Miller what he's got. I have to talk to AJ about what he exactly throws. I didn't get the chance to ask him that. Delivered a fastball there to get the count even at 1-1. Here's his third pitch. That one fooled him. Swung on and missed. He's ahead 1-2. So he is getting the strikes called, as he did in that first batter. Strike three called, that is. Now a couple swings and misses have him ahead 1-2 on Corrales. Kostic trying to end the fifth. Outside corner, ball two. Count even. That one's hit out to left. This one's got some carry on it, and it'll take Grotto back there, but it's hit foul. Hit near staff parking. Looks like my car's okay. Count 2-2. Two outs, top of the fifth. Still 7-0 Blues. Here's the 2-2 from Kostic. That one in there. Strike three called, and he got him. At off speed, fell in there. Kostic sets him down 1-2-3. Two strikeouts mixed in there. That's it for the Mudcats in the fifth. Blues bats will be up in the bottom half in just a moment, leading 7-0. While we have the time, I'd love to thank another one of our generous sponsors, High Street Deli. If you're looking for the best Dutch crunch bread you've ever had, head over to High Street Deli. They'll take care of you. New pitcher out there for the Mudcats. We'll introduce you to him in just a moment. I'm going to take a short break here on the Blue Streaming Network. Thank you so much for hanging out. TJ Clarkson on to start the bottom of the fifth for the Blues. Takes a first tack at that pitch, and it's 0-1 as he fouled it off. I apologize in advance. It is tough to see these Mudcat jersey numbers. They're wearing some white and gray camo with the numbers. They are red, but don't have my glasses today. That was the first mistake I made coming to the ballpark. He's ahead 0-2. I'm going to go with Brady Joyner. It looks like he's wearing an 11. He is a right-hander, and he's ahead 0-2 on TJ Clarkson. Breaking ball in there for strike three, and he got him looking. Here is AJ Esperanza, 0-2 on the day, grounded into a double play in the first, struck out swinging back in the third. And here he is with one out in the bottom of the fifth, takes a fastball high. Swung on and missed. Esperanza in an even count at 1-1. Outside part of the plate, ball two. What am I learning from this experience? When you can't see the jersey numbers, buy binoculars. I am writing it down. 2-1. In there, strike two called. It's back to even. One out in the bottom of the fifth. 7-0 Blues here in San Luis Obispo. Here's the 2-2. Breaking ball is hit by AJ on to first. Banks has it and fields cleanly for the second out. AJ 0-3 on the day. And here is Thomas Tricca, teammates of Craig Miles, both out of George Mason. Thomas Manning right field. That's where he's played all year. Whether he started or pinch hit, takes way inside ball one. That one got away from our new pitcher, possibly Brady Joyner. And again, I apologize, folks. If it is Brady, he's out of Las Vegas, hometown of Nevada. Here's the 1-0. That one high again, and it's ball two. Seven nothing Blues. They did their work early. 4 in the first, 3 in the second, and we're stuck at that number so far. Bottom of the fifth, 2 outs, and a 2-0 pitch to Trinca is high, and now it's 3-0. Three and oh on Trinca, who has grounded out to short in both his appearances. 0-2 on the day. 2 outs, bottom of the fifth. Here's the 3-0. That one is taken for strike one. Three one. That one's popped straight up. How about a souvenir? Oh, they're going to love that. Not caught, but a scrum of children will go take that foul ball home, and Trinca is in a full count. It's 3-2. 2 outs, bottom of the fifth. Here's the payoff pitch. That one is popped up as well. Ranging on is Brown, but he'll let Wolbert out there in right field it for the third out, and that's it. For the Blues in the fifth. That's it for the fifth here at Sinsheimer. This is a good one. Tennis ball toss. Fans have been given tennis balls at random. They are numbered. Their objective is to throw it into that white bucket you see behind home plate. Whoever makes it. You heard it. Jim said a $25 gift certificate. If I had one, I'd give it my best shot as well. Speaking of giving it your best shot, here's Pat Benatar. How about season tickets for a fan? Who doesn't love to see that given out? We're going to start the sixth. Our score still 7-0 Blues. And out for his second inning out of the pen, pitching in relief of Austin Teixeira, is the right-hander 6'3", A.J. Kostic. A.J. set him down 1-2-3, strikeout looking, pop up to the catcher, and another strikeout looking. So he is clean and has done it with minimal pitches. He's been efficient and effective as he warm-ups here and is set to face Mason Levitt, who's due up and will bat to lead off the sixth here for us all at Sinsheimer. And as the case may be, here's Mason. And Kostic looks in and awaits a sign from Austin Shell. Righty on righty to start us off here in the top of the sixth. No out, 7-0 Blues. Here's the first pitch from Kostic. It's low and it's ball one. Levitt, who struck out looking back in the third, 0-for-1 on the day. That one nips the outside corner and it's 1-1. Here's the 1-1. That one's low, bounces it to the plate, and it's 2-1. Lined into left. That's a fair ball. Mason Levitt has the second hit of the day for the Mudcats, and it's a stand-up double to lead off the top of the sixth. Kostic, hometown of Phoenix, Arizona, has spent plenty of time in California playing baseball. Delivers ball one to Tissot Foster, who is, let's see, I have him as 1-for-2. The single back in the third, he was picked off. Fastball's in there, strike one. AJ is another character on this team. A lot of these guys have tremendous senses of humor, love to make each other laugh. AJ, certainly one of those guys. 1-1, breaking ball loops in there for strike two. No outs here in the top of the sixth. If you've been with us for a number of games now, you know I love telling the story about Craig Miles, who had in and out for the first time. Craig, obviously a native of Virginia, thought it was all right. AJ was with us that night, and AJ goes. This one's hit over to short. Mercado has it, fields on to first, and that is the first out. In the process, Levitt advances to third. So AJ finishes his food and decides he wants a milkshake. Apparently had never had one from In-N-Out. Gets the milkshake, sits down, starts to dig into it, and after a few sips says, "This is too sweet." And I sat there and I looked at him. I said, "You did order a milkshake." And he goes, "But not, I didn't ask for this sweet of a milkshake." And everyone just sat there and laughed at him. And then he said, "You know what? I need the calories." And I mean, I've never been disappointed that a milkshake's been too sweet. Top of the sixth, one out. Ahead 0-2 on Mark Wolbert. But AJ, just an absolute character. Had a milkshake that was too sweet. Still powered through and was able to finish something that most of us find quite delicious. That one's fouled off to the right side. Ahead 0-2. Mark Wolbert, he's 0-2 on the day. Ground out to short and strikeout looking. Delivers ball one outside. Top of the sixth, one out. 7-0 Blues. Mason Levitt at third. This one's hit and grounded, and it will find its way into right field. Gets by Ryan Fenn, and that'll score a run. Thank you, Sean. Sean helping me out there. It's not number 11. It's number 10. Logan Haslam was pitching. Only reason I was confused, Sean, was because they have Logan listed as a lefty. Not sure why. Nonetheless, here's Kostic delivering ball one to Kenny DeSell, who is 1-2 on the day, singled back in the first. One runner at first for the Mudcats. It's 7-1 now. Kostic, the 1-0. That one's hit to Samuelson, but by him. DeSell will be safe at first. And Wolbert safe at second. The Mudcats have two men on, and Justin Banks heading to the plate.
Batting down number 40. First in the lineup for the Mudcats. First baseman, Justin Banks.
Justin 0-2 with a strikeout and a ground out. Bats now with ducks on the pond. Runners on first and second for the Mudcats. They've already scored one. They have officially scratched here. It's 7-1 San Luis Obispo. This one's hit on a hop to Ryan Fenn. He'll play it there. Gun on to second in time for the out, but not in time to get Banks at first. Run doesn't score. Runner held at third. Still 7-1. Runners at the corners for the Mudcats.
About
7-1 Blues. Kostic still on the mound. Two outs here in the top of the sixth. Runners on first and third for Solano. That one loops in there for a breaking ball, strike one. Oh, one. Same pitch, same place, same call, strike two. Two outs, top six, 7-1 Blues. Mudcats getting two more hits. this half of the inning and have struck. That one's fouled back. It's 0-2 still. All one. 1-2 ahead now. Petrushka awaits the 1-2. That one's fouled straight back. Another souvenir. Count still 1-2 on Petrushka doing the DHing today. Bats with runners on the corners. Fastball high as the count gets even. Two, two. Swung on and missed strike three. Kostic sets him down, but not before the Mudcats plate a run. It's now 7-1 Blues. Runners left on first and third. It's the bottom of the sixth. We'll head to the bottom of the sixth right after this. That's it for the Mudcats half of the sixth. It's 7-1. Seven to one, our score. I'm going to take a short break. I'll be right back with you on the Blue Streaming Network. Thanks for hanging out. Bottom of the sixth, Ruben Mercado to lead things off for the Blues. Still out there and on the mound for the Mudcats, as I just learned, is Logan Haslam. Here comes set and deal to Mercado, who has been hit by a pitch and popped out to short. Pops one up here on the infield and ranging on to make the play. Is Banks. One out, bottom of the sixth, 7-1 Blues. Here's Ryan Fenn as we work our way back to the top of the order. Haslam deals one that gets away from Corrales behind the plate, and it's 1-0. Fenn has reached in all three of his plate appearances now, reaching on an error, fielder's choice, and a walk. We're in the sixth now, and this is his fourth at-bat, his team leading 7-1. On fireworks night here at Sinsheimer Park. Here's the 1-0. That one's in there for a strike, and the count's even. One-one. That one's hit on a hop. Foster has it at short. Guns over to first in time for the second out. Fenn fails to reach on his fourth plate appearance.
Now batting number 15, Jason Grotto.
6-3 on the ground out. Here's Grotto, who has walked, singled, and flown out to center. 7-1 our score here in the bottom of the sixth. Blues lead and Haslam set to deliver the first pitch. That one, breaking pitch in there, strike one. Gets a head on Grotto here early. Grotto playing left field today. One of three positions he's capable of. We've seen him play this season. Takes a fastball high, and it's 1-1. As the sun begins to set here at Sinsheimer, over the mound and half of right field and a bit of center. Here's the 1-1. Haslam deals low and outside. It's 2-1. Two outs, bottom of the sixth. 7-1 Blues. Here's the 2-1. Grotto does not offer at it. It's 3-1 now as he takes. Grotto hits this one on a line to Foster. He's already grounded out once to him and ground out a second time. Foster guns over to first. That's it for the sixth. After six innings, it is 7-1 still. Grotto grounds out to short. Back to the Solano bats in the top of the seventh.
We've added a fourth horse, the Ghost Rider. Ghost Rider, if Ghost Rider wins, everybody with the program gets new score, blue score, price it. So let's get up the horses to the gate. And they're off. As the race starts, it looks like Apple of My Eye has a commanding lead, followed up by Purple Haze and Purple Haze is now pulling ahead. Oh my goodness, there's the Ghost Rider. The Ghost Rider jumps into the middle of the race. The other horses just give up. It looks like Purple Haze is running backwards. Scared to death. And Ghost Rider wins the day. That means anyone with the program gets blue score, you score pricing for the rest of the inning, regardless of what happens on the field.
Some defensive changes for the Blues. It's Craig Miles taking the place of Mason Grotto in left. Taking the place of Tate Samuelson is indeed Grotto, who will now play third. We just mentioned he's capable of playing multiple positions. And a new pitcher out there for the Blues. We'll introduce you to him in just a moment.
Miles
in left. Connor Kosteka will take the place of Ryan Fenn at second. The two trade positions. Rest remains the same. Pitcher on the mound is the lefty Jared Hart. So Hart on for the Blues, protecting a 7-1 lead here in the top of the seventh. At the plate for the Mudcats to lead off the inning is E.J. Brown, center fielder today. Lefty on righty, Jared Hart out of the pen. Brown at the plate. We're set to start the seventh here with the Blues leading 7-1. Hart delivers a ball on the outside part of the plate. 1-0. Here's the 1-0, way inside. Brown takes ball two. No outs, top of the seventh, 7-1, our score. EJ awaits the third pitch of the at-bat, and he takes it for ball three. Three-oh the count on to Brown. Hart to the plate. That one in there for a strike. It's now 3-1. Get you the numbers here for Jared Hart and his appearances. Ahead or behind, 3-1 on Brown. That one in there for a strike, and it's worked it full. 3-2 now. So Hart coming into this one. 3 1/3 innings pitched. 3 strikeouts, 2 earned runs, 4 hits, no walks. In danger of that here. That one's hit straight back at him and up to center field. EJ Brown has himself a single to lead off the inning. Brown singles. And that brings up Justin Claxton manning the hot corner today. Justin has singled and popped out to the catcher. That's been Austin Schell today for the Blues. It still is after their defensive substitutions. Hart stands in after surrendering the single and deals to Claxton with no outs in the top of the seventh. 7-1 Blues our score. Here's the first pitch. That one is in there for strike one. It's ahead here early.
Not until you're not going to let me have one until you get your hanging chair up here.
Yeah, right.
All right.
Brown at first, singled to lead off the inning. Here's the 0-1 from Hart onto Claxton.
Actually, it'd be pretty funny if you're like, look, give me the sausage chair for
Keenan. Swung on and missed. Ahead 0-2 and in control.
You never know.
Oh and two now.
How's the crowd looking, Max?
Here in the top of the seventh, no outs. 7-1 our score. Hart. Schell tries to throw it a second. Came out of his hand awkwardly, and it bounces. So EJ Brown, who singled, now steals second, is in scoring position, and the count is 1-2 onto Claxton as that third pitch of the at bat was a ball. Years and I don't want to turn 4 people away. 1-2. Hart steps off. Brown's at second after singling and stealing second. Claxton's at the plate in a 1-2 count. He's 1-for-2 on the day.
Hey, Jim, do we have any more on-field promotions?
Hart to the plate, way inside, and it's even at 2-2. Here's the 2-2 from Hart, way inside again, and it's 3-2. Full count on to Claxton. Mudcats get the leadoff man on. He's now in scoring position in the form of EJ Brown, and we await a payoff pitch from the lefty, Jared Hart. Breaking ball, got him swinging, and a key out there. Strikeout for Claxton. That's the first out of the top of the seventh. Blues trying to protect that 7-1 lead. It was at 1.7-0. Mudcats tacked one on back in the sixth. And here we are with Brown at second. Anthony Corrales to the plate. Here's the first pitch. Hart deals inside, ball one. Corrales 0-for-2 has grounded out to third and struck out looking. Taking off for third, Brown gunning there. Schell, and he's safe. Brown steals third. And now that possible second run for the Mudcats just 90 feet away. One's all around, 1-1 count, one out in the inning, and one runner on at third. We're in the top of the seventh, and it's 7-1 Blues. Here's Jared Hart, sophomore at Illinois State, teammate of Ryan Cermak. That one is fouled off. Corrales now in a 1-2 count. Hart's hometown is Cedar Park, Texas. But also at Illinois State University. As Corrales awaits a 1-2. Runner at third. Corrales swings and misses. Back-to-back Ks for Jared Hart. And that run at third in danger of being stranded. E.J. Brown, who singled to lead off the inning, stole second. Claxton struck out. Stole third, and now Corrales strikes out. Two outs top of the seventh. And here's Mason Levitt, who doubled back in the sixth. That led off the inning. Hart looks in and deals. That one's hit out to center. Cermak is positioned perfectly, and he's under it for the third out. So that run is indeed stranded at third, and it remains 7-1 Blues. And after that top of the seventh is over, it is time to stretch here at Cinsheimer. For those of you wondering, we are going to have the fireworks here for you on the live stream. If the Blues do indeed hang on, we'll get you a post-game interview with a player. And then keep it here 15 minutes after the game is over for the fireworks show. I'm going to take a short break during this seventh inning stretch. I'll be back with you for the bottom half of the inning with the Blues leading 7-1. Thanks for hanging out on the Blue Streaming Network. Set to start the bottom of the seventh for the Blues. They lead 7-1. It's Ryan Cermak leading things off. He's reached in all three of his plate appearances. Reached on a fielder's choice in the first, walked in the second, and doubled back in the fourth. And still on for the Mudcats. The man who wasn't named early, but it is indeed Logan Haslam, who delivers ball one to Cermak. Cermak, who, of course, homered last night back in the ninth. That made it 14-0. That one's hit on a hop to Foster. He ranges on and throws over to first in time for the out. So he gets Cermak, and it's a 6-3 ground out to start things out here for the Blues in the bottom of the seventh. And here's Austin Schell, who has done some work today. Two RBI double back in the first, singled, and then was out at second in the process, scoring one more run. So he has three RBIs. And in his last at-bat, he took a walk. There's one out for him in the bottom of the seventh. Bases are empty, his team leading 7-1. But what a day it's been for Austin Schell. Awaits the first pitch from Haslam. That one's low for ball one. Here's the 1-0 to Schell. Breaking ball in there for a strike. We're even at 1-1. Cermak, who grounded out to start the inning. It'll be Schell awaiting a 1-1 here from Logan Haslam. That one is outside, ball two. And Schell works his way ahead in the count. Again, we'll have the fireworks show for you here on the Blue Streaming Network. Set to come on 15 minutes after the game is over. Keep it right here for you. Hopefully have a post-game interview sandwiched in there for you to enjoy. That one's fouled off, and it's 2-2. The count to Austin Schell. One out in the bottom of the seventh, and 7-1 Blues our score. That breaking ball way high, able to corral it, was Corrales. And the count will be full. Full count. Payoff pitch from Haslam. Schell hits that one to left. It's looping, and it'll drop for a base hit. So Schell has reached in all four of his plate appearances. He now singles. A pinch hitter for the Blues is Craig Miles. He is pinch hitting in place of Tate Samuelson. Tate, who ended that first inning with a bang, a two-run home run. That made it 4-0, and since then it's been 7-1. Blues leading the bottom half of the seventh. Craig Miles, the switch hitter, batting from the left side against the righty Logan Haslam. Austin Schell just singled, and here comes Craig. Samuelson the day officially 1-for-3, two-run homer, two strikeouts looking. Craig takes strike one. One out, bottom seven. Haslam throws over to first to check on Schell.
Yeah, that's the sinkhole. That's what we're calling it. No, it's a scooper head.
Schell takes off for second. Haslam guns over the head of Foster. Schell is safe at second. Now we'll be safe at third. So Schell had second stolen, and then the throw from Haslam gets into center field, and in the process, Austin takes third. Runner at third now, and the count's still 1-1 to Craig Miles.
You believe we've been safe in the first place?
He took off before the pitcher went, so he stepped off and threw it across his house
today in the center field. Never mind. He might have been safe. A perfect throw.
1-1. Outside. 2-1 to Craig. Miles still looking for that first hit on the season. He's walked four times. So in his pinch hit appearances, he has gotten on. 2-1 from Haslam. Craig hits that one softly to third. Going home with it is Claxton, and it gets away from Corrales. Schell will score. Miles into second. Another Mudcats miscue results in a run for the Blues. It's 8-1. Miles, who hit one softly to third, Claxton fielded it, threw onto Corrales. Corrales lost his handle on it. It got away from him. Miles is safe at second as a result, and Schell came around from third to steal. Two errors lead into another run. 8-1 now our score, with the Blues leading. Haslam, first pitch. That one's high. It's TJ Clarkson at the plate. Still in the bottom of the seventh, still only one out. Craig Miles at second, TJ Clarkson at the plate. Haslam steps off, and Miles heads back into second. First pitch, second pitch in there for a strike. It's 1-1. TJ is 2-for-3 on the day, 2 singles and a strikeout looking. This is his fourth plate appearance. Moved down from 4th to 6th in the lineup today. First time we've seen that change. That one is popped up in the left. Ranging on is DeSalle. Not in time, or no play can be made. It's in foul territory. And Clarkson is behind 1-2. TJ batting with Miles at second, 1-2 count, one out in the bottom of the 7th. Breaking ball high. 2-2 now. Blues officially with 9 hits on the afternoon. 3 errors now for the Mudcats, costing them a run. Here in the 7th to make it 8-1. 2-2 now to TJ. Logan Haslam still out there, set to start, or is in the middle of his 3rd inning of relief. Has pitched 2 1/3 innings. Here's the 2-2 to TJ. Makes a look back at second. Looks twice, in fact, and now delivers. That one is outside, ball 3. Count will be full. Keep it here after we're done. Have the post-game show for you. Player interview. The Blues hang on and the fireworks show. Payoff pitch to Clarkson. Way high over his head, and he'll take a walk. And in the process, the wild pitch results in Miles at third base. Pitch hitting for AJ Esperanza is Sage Para. Meeting on the mound for the Mudcats, Logan Haslam, the right-hander, still out there. It'll be Sage Para, a pinch hitter for the Blues, up to bat. Craig Miles is still safe at third. It's still 8-1 Blues. And Haslam remains out there. One out, bottom of the 7th. 8-1 Blues. One out still. Haslam dealing to Para. Sage takes ball 1 low. Sage Para at Westmont University, a senior there. That one's hit in the left field, a base hit and an RBI for Sage Para. He singles to bring in the 9th run for the Blues. So Para singles in the 9th run of the day for the Blues. And here's Thomas Trinka. One out. Still in the bottom of the 7th. In an inning that has seen the Blues tack on 2 more, Trinka lifts this one out to right. Wolbert is under it for the 2nd out, and Para doesn't tag. That one gets away, but momentarily. Clarkson is at 2nd. Para's at 1st. And here comes Connor Kosteka,
is for Mercado, who's number 9, Connor Costeca.
Here's Connor Costeca to bat with 2 out in the bottom of the 7th. Blues leading 9-1. They've tacked on 2. They have 2 men on. And it's Costeca's first plate appearance. Haslam looks in and deals, and that one low and outside, ball 1. Costeca switching positions with Ryan Fenn. Fenn moves over to short. Costeca manning second base currently. Awaits a 1-0 from Logan Haslam. Fouls that one straight back and against the netting here at Zinsheimer. So when we say keep it here, after this one's over, this stream will end. The stream for this game will end, and then we'll start up another one as soon as this one ends. We'll start up a second stream. That one swung on and missed by Costeca. It's 1-2. So after this one ends, this will end. When the game's over, the stream will end. And then we'll start another one with a post-game show and a player interview, and then position the camera to get you guys the fireworks show. So just keep it here after the game's over on this YouTube channel. Thanks for hanging out here on the Blue Streaming Network. That one's in there. Strike 3 called on Costeca. You can't believe it, but he'll be sat down to end the inning. Blues get it to 9-1. 5 away from what they did last night, trying to upstage themselves here. That's it for 7. We'll head into the 8th with our score 9-1. Now this is, if you can see, this is the Footloose race. Bring out a bunch of kids. They dump all their shoes out in left field, and they got to go get them. They got to get their shoes. Whoever gets them first wins. More fun here being had at Zinsheimer. What's cool about this crowd, and it is fireworks night. Again, keep it here on this YouTube channel for the stream of the fireworks show and a player interview after this one ends officially. Everyone bringing out their lawn chairs, their towels. It's cooled down here. It's about 70 degrees, I should say. Dropped about 10 degrees from first pitch as the sun is setting here.
All right, here we go.
Top of the 8th coming. Mudcats trailing 9-1. Blues with an even 10 hits. Mudcats with 5. Blues trying to win their 2nd in a row. Unofficially. Got to keep saying that. They'll be unofficially 6-1 if they hold on to this 8-run lead. Got to wait for the kids to clear out of left field so we can start this 8th inning. Jared Hart will still be out there for the Blues. Set to pitch his 2nd inning of relief. And he'll lead it off. Still waiting for this to end.
I don't care where you go to a baseball game. We don't know if it's on a better show.
Yes, we do. Set to start the top of the 8th here at Zinsheimer. Foster to lead things off in the top of the eighth for the Mudcats. 9-1 game here. Jared Hart still on for the Blues. Starting his second inning of relief. Lefty looks into the righty at the plate. Breaking pitch drops in for strike one. Fastball low. Count even now, 1-1. Tonight the fans get what looks to be, won't get ahead of myself, but looks to be a Blues win. Swung on and missed. Hart gets ahead 1-2 on Foster. So they get him come out to Sinsheimer. They get a Blues win on this perfect afternoon. Now evening. Nice little fireworks show. One, two. That one's hit by TJ into right. Foster has a leadoff hit. It'll be a single as Trinka throws in from right. Leadoff single for Foster. Here comes Mark Wahlberg. Hart looks in. Breaking pitch over the plate. Strike one. He has led off back-to-back batters with that beautiful pitch. It's got a ton of movement on it out of his left hand. And ahead 0-1 on Wahlberg. Foster at first. That one's fouled straight back towards our merchandise booth. 0-2 now as Hart gets ahead. Oh, 2 from Hart. Way inside, ball one. Wolbert, who grounded out to second in the first and struck out looking back in the third. Blues pitching has done its job. The only one run scored off of A.J. Kostic, who is in his second inning of relief, second inning pitching this season for the right-hander. Here's the 1-2 from Hart. That one swung on and missed. Got Wolbert down. So after the leadoff single, Wolbert's the first out via the K. And here comes Kenny DeSell. DeSell, single back in the first, ground out to second, back in the fourth. Here to bat with one out in the top of the eighth, his team trailing by eight. Again, this is the first of a three-game weekend series between these two teams, the Slow Blues from the CCL Southern Division and the Mudcats from the CCL Northern Division. So non-conference play here. The Blues technically played their first conference game yesterday in an unofficial victory at Compton Youth Academy against the Barons, but right now it'll say they haven't played a conference game. That'll change after the Mudcats series. It's 1-0. Hart deals the breaking pitch, low ball two. Still trying to compile 6 wins in 7 games for San Luis Obispo. Good start to their season so far. As Matt Sox put it lightly yesterday, winning is fun. These guys are doing a lot of it and having a good time. This one's popped up onto center. Cermak ranging on. Now finds himself in right center and records the second out. So DeSell flies out to center, and it's 2 outs now in the top of the eighth for the Mudcats. Jared Hart 1 out away from completing his second inning of work. Now, if you're not a follower of the Mudcats, if you're not from Solano, say you're a Blues fan or you're a casual viewer, when I got here and took a look at their logo, I saw a catfish. And I thought to myself, is that a Mudcat? So I Googled it. The flathead catfish, also called a Mudcat, ranging from the lower Great Lakes region to northern Mexico. and she got a kick out of that reading that Wikipedia. And I learned what a Mudcat was today as we welcome Solano in for this three-game series. It's 1-1. Two, Justin Banks. Two outs, top eight. That one's half-heartedly swung on. It was a check swing that went around, and Banks now in the 1-2 count against the lefty Jared Hart, trying to set down the Mudcats after a leadoff single. That one's barely made contact with, and it finds its way to the backstop. It's still 1-2 with two outs. 9-1 our score, Blues lead. Right here on this YouTube channel on the Blue Streaming Network for your 2021 Blue summer season. After this one ends, this stream will end. We'll start another one up with a post-game interview, and then after that, it'll be just in time for fireworks. Position the camera to the point where you can see the show. Here's the 1-2. Way inside, breaking pitch that, if it was a fastball, would have hit Banks. Instead, it breaks loose for ball two. No, I have not been told if I will call the fireworks show. I've never done that before. I could add that to my resume. Not sure how it would work. I'd be saying colors. Swung on and missed strike three. That ends the inning for the Mudcats. So after the leadoff single, Hart sets him down 1-2-3 with two Ks. Nine to one our score through 7.5. While we have a moment, I want to thank another one of our generous sponsors, Injectors Direct. Sponsors for when the Blues score, you score, which when the Blues score in an inning, for the rest of that inning, Miller Lights and wine are just $3. Very popular here at Sinsheimer. Again, there's our sponsors for when the Blues score, you score. Injectors Direct, the best parts, best prices, best service, period.
Our thanks to Kimberly Global Real Estate, Hunco Senior Center, Lowell Brands, Altrier Associates, CPA, Minor City Cardware, all over the area, and the Positive Legal, sponsoring Blue State Law.
Bottom of the eighth, 9-1 Blues. Ryan Fenn at the plate. Fenn reached in his first three plate appearances, grounded out to short back in the sixth. Here he is, still facing Logan Haslam out of the Mudcats dugout. Bullpen, excuse me. 1-0, Ben takes ball one. Here's the second pitch. That one gets by Corrales, and it's 2-0. Fenn takes strike one on the outside corner. 2-1 now, no outs, bottom of the eighth. This one's lined into right center. That'll drop for a base hit. It'll inch towards the wall, and with that, Fenn will be into second with a stand-up double to lead off the inning. Well, we saw the Blues have eight runs through, I want to say the sixth or seventh, maybe even earlier than that, maybe the fifth. So they had eight runs, and then they tacked on six in the top of the ninth. If you were with us last night, it was fun. It was funny, especially with the sprinkler system coming off in the middle of Tate Samuelson's at-bat. That one is taken high Ball one, it's Mason Grotto at the plate now, batting with Fenn at second. He just doubled to lead off the bottom of the eighth. 9-1 Blues. Grotto, another at-bat with a runner in scoring position, takes high ball two. Grotto has walked, singled, flown out to center, and grounded out to short. Awaits the 2-0 from Haslam. Takes a look back at Fenn at second, and Grotto takes a third straight fastball high. Count now 3-0. Corrales having a conversation with Logan. Haslam out there in his fourth inning of work now. Has completed three. Looking for that first out here in the eighth. Blues already greeted him with a double to start things off here. The 11th hit of the day for the Blues. Here's the 3-0. Grotto takes low ball four and will take first base. Blues on the day, again, 9 runs, 11 hits. Only 4 extra base hits. 3 doubles. And the 1 homer by Samuelson. Speaking of homers, here's Ryan Cermak. First pitch from Haslam is taken on the outside part of the plate for strike one. So it's Fenn at second. He doubled. Grotto at first. He walked. And there's no outs here in the bottom of the eighth. 9-1 our score. Blues lead. Capacity crowd here at Sinsheimer. 0-1, Cermak takes a breaking ball that drops in for strike two. Temperature's cooling down now. It's about that time of the night where I wish I had my sweatshirt here in the press box with me. We are in an open-air press box. Best view in the house. Cermak lines that one to left. Fenn will come around to score from third. And it's an RBI single for Ryan Cermak. The Blues hit double digits for the second straight game. It's 10-1. Twelve hits on the day for on the evening for the Blues. 10 runs on 12 hits. So these bats continue to sizzle. Speaking about a man who's on fire, it's Austin Schell. He's driven in 3 on the day. First pitch, swung on and missed. Doubled in 2 back in the first. In the second, he would single and try for 2, drive in a run but be out at second. He'd then walk in the fourth and single back in the seventh. Here he is now with ducks on the pond. Runners first for the Blues and an 0-1 count. Austin takes ball one. Count will be even now. The 1-1 to Schell. I think it's better of that one as it's in the dirt for ball two. Well, Austin having a day that looked like he may have had yesterday if the infield wasn't positioned so perfectly. He ended the day 1-for-5, had 4 really well-hit balls. 2 were lineouts. He's making amends for it today. In a 10-1 game, he's responsible for 3 on the board. That one gets away from Corrales. He has to slide and field it. Schell now in a dangerous 3-1 count. The 3-1 count always dangerous for any pitcher on the mound, but when Schell has done what he's done today and on this season, it is a code red. Here's the 3-1 from Haslam. Schell takes high ball 4. He'll take a walk, and every Blue has reached that has come to the plate. They've gone double walk, RBI single, and now another walk. Here's Craig Miles, left-handed, or switch hitter, batting left-handed here in this AB. Craig found his way at second after walking and then finding his way at second on a fielder's choice. That one is high, ball one. 10-1 our score. A dozen hits for the Blues. 1-0 to Miles. Craig takes one on the outside corner. Count even now. Craig has had one at-bat with the bases loaded this season. He grounded out to short. There were two outs when he batted. There's none now. Bumper-to-bumper traffic on the base pass. Miles swings, whips that one foul to left. Count will be 1-2. Chance for Craig to scratch in the hit column this season. And in a game that, I mean, they're up 9, but it would be an awesome moment to see Craig come through here with the bases loaded. 1-2, Miles swings and loops that one out to short. Foster is under it, makes the play. No one will tag up. Miles pops out to short. Here's TJ. Out of the University of Utah, first baseman today. He is 2-for-3 officially. He has reached in 3 of his plate appearances, 2 singles in the first and third, a strikeout looking in the fifth, and a walk back in the seventh. We're in the eighth now, and Miles was the first out. Bases remain loaded. 10-1 our score. We're in the bottom of the eighth. Haslam deals the 1-0 to Clarkson. That one is swung on and fouled straight back. Count even now. Blues have done this a number of times where they get the first 3 men on to load the bases. In this case, it's been the first 4 men on. They brought a run in the process. That was courtesy of Ryan Cermak, his 6th RBI on the season. Clarkson takes a half-hearted hack, gets all air, and it's 1-2. Still 1 out, bottom of the 8th. Hope you're enjoying this one as much as I am. Zach Ebrahim with you here at Cinsheimer on the Blue Streaming Network. Bases loaded for Clarkson in a 1-2 count. Inside, gets away from Corrales momentarily. It'll be 2-2. Logan Haslam still out there for the Mudcats. Ten to one, 2-2 to TJ. Let's say you went around. On the check swing, TJ couldn't hold up and strikes out with the bases loaded. 2 outs now for Sage Pera. Bases remain loaded. Score remains 10-1. Pera out of Westmont University, hometown of Templeton, California. That one's hit out to left. It'll drop. Throw in from left is cut off. 2 score on the 2 RBI single by Sage Pera. How about an even dozen? 12-1 Blues. And here's Thomas Trinka up again. 0-for-4 on the day. He's the only Blue starter who hasn't reached. Grounded out twice to short, flown out twice to right. Men on first and second for him here with his team up 12-1 in the bottom of the eighth. Takes a healthy hack at the first one and fouls it off. He's 0-1. So Pera, those are his first RBIs, his first hit. What a way to do it. Make it 12-1 Blues. We thought we were getting fireworks after the game. We've gotten fireworks during the game from this Blues offense. Doing it yet again for the second straight night. 26 runs in two games so far. Trinka hits this one to short. Foster has it. It gets by him into center field, coming around to score. Is Shell. How about a Baker's dozen? 13-1 as they continue to pile on. An E6 brings in the 13th run. Correction, that'll go down as a base hit and an RBI for Thomas Trinka. Still brings in the 13th run, though. Men at the corners now for Kosteka. Erase the error off my score sheet. My apologies. It's a clean RBI single for Thomas Trinka. That one just got by Foster. It was hard hit on the ground. Runners at first and third for Kosteka in an 0-1 count. Two outs, bottom of the eighth. Takes strike two, counting out 0-2. Blues are up 13-1. They've got 14 hits, possibly 15. We'll await this one to be over just to double check, but what a night it's been. Only the one extra base hit in this inning in which they've plated four, and that led off the inning. Kosteka takes inside. It gets away from Corrales. How about another one coming in and trying to score? He's safe. The tag was not put down in time for Logan Haslam. They've scored 14 runs for the second consecutive game. What a performance it's been. Miscues by the Mudcats, of course, helping that cause, but with Kosteka at the plate, the Blues have sent all nine to the plate for the second consecutive. They sent 10 to the plate in the top of the ninth last night in Compton, and now they've officially sent nine to the plate. Kosteka in a 1-2 count with two outs. 14-1 Blues, still two outs in the bottom of the eighth. 2-2. Kosteka fouls that one off. Got six more outs to go here. We know you're eager for the fireworks, but the Blues continue to give them to us on the field. If you consider runs fireworks, there's been a lot. 14-1, another ugly football score. Not sure where you'd get the one. But 28 runs for the Blues in two games, just incredible. Piling on, and the offensive numbers continue to skyrocket, giving these fans something to cheer about before the flashing lights are even in the sky. Here's the 2-2 to Kosteka. That one's way inside, and it's ball three. The man at second is Thomas Trinka. He just drove in a run on an RBI single. Full count to Kosteka. Two outs, bottom eight. 14-1 Blues. Got the same number of hits as runs. Payoff pitch. Kosteka hits that one softly to second. It's Levitt on to first to end the inning. Blues score five in the bottom of the eighth. Send all nine men to the plate. Tack on five. It's 14-1. Mudcats bats will be up in the top of the ninth. New pitcher out there for the Blues. We'll introduce you to him in a moment. In the meantime, how about we shout out another generous sponsor of the Blues. Shout out to Splash Cafe. If you're looking for the best chowder in town, check out our friends at Splash Cafe. They'll take care of you. Also, Firestone Walker Brewing Company. Go check their stuff out. Must be 21 or older to visit their website. Must be 21 or older to consume their product. We remind you to drink responsibly. 14-1, new pitcher for the Blues is number 30, Zach McCleave. Zach is hilarious. I mentioned this in his last outing. Guy who loves to make the guys laugh. Kind of that half sidearm delivery out of McCleave. Teammates of TJ Clarkson and Matt Sox. Matt Sox, who dominated last night. TJ Clarkson, who's had a great game tonight. And Zach McCleave, the second Ute out of the University of Utah to make his appearance here today. Tonight, I should say. Fireworks night at Sinsheimer. 14-1 our score. Everyone's sticking around because they know what's going on after this one. Blues looking to get a win. They lead by 13, that unofficial sixth win. This is a non-conference game. The next two against the Mudcats will be the same. So far, the Blues have only lost once to opponents from the CCL North. That was on opening day to the Walnut Creek Crawdads. Here we are in the top of the ninth. We've made it here again, top of the ninth. Will this one end officially? We'll wait and see. Here's Petrushka, my mistake. Jordan Petrushka doing the DHing today. Waits the first pitch from McCleave. Swings and misses through that one. It's 0-1. A one from McCleave. Hit up to center, ranging on to make the play is Fenn. Throws wide of Clarkson. It'll get by him. Leadoff man reaches. Mudcats get Petrushka on to lead off the top of the ninth. And here's E.J. Brown. E.J. Brown singled to lead off the seventh. He'd steal second. And Claxton would strike out. Then he'd steal third. Corrales would strike out. And he'd be left stranded at third. Pinch runner now for the Mudcats. So Petrushka reaches. There'll now be a pinch runner on. E.J. Brown will still be at the plate. And Zach McCleave still on the mound. The Blues still leading 14-1. First pitch is a ball for McCleave. Pinch runner for the Mudcats, Tyler Durant. He's on first base. To 1 our score. And are they saying the count is 1-1? That may be the case. In there, strike two. Put a question mark at the end of that one. Brown still at the plate. Durant at first to pinch runner. Drops down and delivers ball two. Count even at 2-2. It is 2-1. My mistake. 2-1. That one's in there for strike two. That clarifies it. 2-2 onto Brown. Durant at first. No outs in the top of the ninth. Top of the ninth here at Sinsheimer. 14-1. Second straight night, the Blues have scored 14 runs. Is that right? It is. That one's way outside. Durant will take second on the wild pitch. 3-2 the count now to Brown. E.J. Brown awaits the payoff pitch from McCleave. Swung on and missed. Strike three. McLeod gets a K. That's the first out of the top of the ninth. Brown strikes out. Durant at second after Jordan Petrushka singled to lead off the inning. McLeave delivers strike one. 0-0, 0-1. Make sure to stick around after this one. Post-game show, player interview, fireworks show. A lot going on here on the Blue Streaming Network. Swung on and missed. Strike two. McLeave ahead 0-2. In there, strike three called. Off speed, moved its way over the plate, and it's back-to-back strikeouts as he sits down Claxton for the second out. McLeave now to face Corrales. Two outs, top of the ninth, 14-1 Blues. Tyler Durant's the runner on second, a pinch runner at that. One more out, and this thing will be over. Strike one. Blues one out away from that unofficial sixth win. Six wins in seven games. 28 runs in two games for them now. 14 runs, 14 hits. That one is taken for a ball. This one's going to end. I'll go grab a player. I'll surprise you with who it is. We'll keep it. We know you're waiting for the fireworks show. We'll have it for you momentarily. About 15 minutes after this one's over, we'll have it here on the Blue Streaming Network. 1-1. That one is called strike two. And we're a strike away from a Blues victory at home. Their second win at home this season. This one, dominance from start to finish. Started in the first. And they scored all the way up until the eighth. They actually saved their best for last, plating five in the bottom of the eighth. Here's McLeave, a 1-2. Zach deals. Low ball two. This crowd eager to shout and scream here in San Luis Obispo. Righty on righty. McLeave on to Corrales. It's a 2-2 count. You hear some cowbells. You hear some shouting. Here's the pitch. Called strike three. That's the game. Blues win. Blues win. Second win at home. This one near final. 14-1. Officially, we finished it. No sprinklers. Unofficially, your Blues are 6-1. They have won 6 of 7 games. They have been dominant in all 6 of the victories. Hey, San Luis, what do you say? The Blues just won tonight. Stay tuned for the post-game show, a player interview. Stay tuned for the fireworks show after that. Count it down now. Should be about 15 minutes from now. I'll be right back. Thanks for hanging out with me tonight in the Blue Streaming Network. I've been Zach Ebrahim. I'm going to grab a player for you on the post-game show. We'll get you a player interview with someone who was terrific today. We could choose anyone. I'll surprise you with who it is. and then a fireworks show coming up right after that. Stay right here. I'll be right back. Blues Live post game show. Zach Ebrahim, Austin Schell. Austin, you've gotten an at bat in every game. You got a presence at the plate out there. Brought in the first two runs. What pitch was it off of?
He left the fastball over the plate, and I caught it out front, and luckily it was fair. So,
now, talk about what this offense has been able to do. You guys played 14 runs in back-to-back games. Okay, defense has been phenomenal. Pitching has been great. All around, how does it feel to be 6-1?
It feels amazing. We get along super good as a team, which is what I think carries over to, you know, how good we're performing. And we have, like, contagious hitting, so one guy gets on, it carries on to the next guy, put up good at-bats, and then next thing you know, it's a crooked number.
Now, you've DH'd and you've caught. So when you're catching, how's your relationship with this pitching staff? Have you guys synced up pretty fast?
Oh, yeah. It's awesome. We get together a lot, so I know the pitchers pretty well by now. And, yeah, know all their stuff, and they're really fun to catch.
For sure. How's it been like playing under Coach Bob Miller? He's a guy who, when I talk to him, he just wants you guys to play hard and get better. He doesn't really – like, you guys are winning. That makes it even more fun. But how's it been playing for Coach Miller?
Oh, it's awesome. He's the best. We, you know, he preaches like development and getting each individual better. And we do that. And by doing that, I think it kind of like puts us together more and we win more games like that. So,
absolutely. Thanks for taking the time, Austin.
Yeah, of course.
Seriously. Austin Schell, three RBIs, excuse me. Don't let me short shoot you like that. He's been getting on base like crazy. A lot of extra base hits for Austin. Thanks for joining us, man.
Of course. Seriously. Thank you.
Yeah, of course. All right.
Touching me. Run!
We are now about 5 minutes out. 5 minutes out. We'd like to remind you that we are going to turn all the lights off, including the scoreboard. It will be very dark. If you want to start collecting your children, don't forget, we just got down beer sales right as the lights go off. We have time to get more lubrication and more.
Are we like actually good? Is that why we keep winning? Or like why are
It's like a mix of,
why are we destroying them?
It's like a mix of
two minutes to the show. Sit tight, guys. We'll have it for you in a sec.
Thank you. She's
not getting it. I saw she was in a chair. Yeah. Oh. Jesus,
I hope they got that right. 30 seconds. Kids, please find your parents. All right, let's count those together, folks. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
Step as you are headed out of the stadium and have a safe drive home.